In this video, we are going to discuss chapter 9, class 11th chemistry, that is hydrogen. One of the compound of hydrogen, that is hydride. This video covers the following topics, that is what are hydrides, then what are the classification of hydrides, or we can say in how many categories hydrides can be classified, we are going to discuss in this video, and what are the uses of these hydrides. Now these are a very specific topic and the questions come maximum time in the MCQ form. So side by side we are going to discuss what can be a MCQ which is formed from this topic. Now the hydrogen is that element which can combine with all elements, whether it is a metal or whether it is a non-metal, and only except noble gas. So hydrogen combine with all elements and give a binary compound. Now why that compound is known as a binary compound? Because it contains only two things. One will be the hydrogen and other one will be the element EHX. This binary compound of hydrogen is called as a hydride. So we can say hydrogen reacts with all element except noble gas under certain condition to give a binary compound, and that binary compound is called as hydride, having general formula EHX, where E is the element and X is the number of hydrogen atom which is used. For example, NaH, MgH2, BeH2, CH4 and the NiH. So this is the first question, what are hydrides? Now we will move
ahead. That is ionic hydrides.
What are the different classification
of molecular hydrides? And the third one is the metallic
or depending upon the nature
of
element.
Now we will discuss,
for example, hydrogen is combining with any of the element. So depending upon the nature of element, hydrides are classified into three types. Now as the name itself suggests, ionic hydrides, whenever hydrogen is reacting with more electropositive element. Now for example, if hydrogen is reacting with sodium, if hydrogen is reacting with calcium, that is group 1 s block element, that is group 1 and group 2 element except magnesium and beryllium. In that case we will going to discuss that they will form the covalent hydrides, but right now we are emphasis on this topic, that whenever it is reacting with more electropositive element, it form the ionic hydrides. And for example, NaH, Na plus, H minus, LiH, Li plus, H minus. So what is the force of attraction between them? It is a similar that in the ionic compound, that is electrostatic force of attraction. Now because of this force of attraction, they possess high melting and boiling point. Other property also similar to ionic compound, that is in the solid state, they are non-conductor, or we can say insulator, but in the molten state, since they produce ions, hence they are a good conductor of electricity. So it is a general property similar to that of the ionic compound, that is ionic hydrides in solid state is non-conductor, whereas in the molten state they are the good conductor of electricity. Whenever ionic hydrides are subjected to electrolysis, then oxidation will take place at anode, and meaning hydrogen gas is released here. So what happened? 2H minus plus minus of 2 electron, or we can say forming H2 plus 2 electrons. So oxidation takes place at hydrogen, and at the same time reduction takes place at the metal. So what happened, this is not necessary, you have to learn this point. We are only discussing that on subjection to or when we can say they are subjected to electrolysis, then hydrogen gas is released, which confirms that existence of hydrogen in the form of hydride ion. Since hydride ion is present in the reaction, it is then only producing the hydrogen gas. Now, if we discuss what is the stability. Now, there are different type of hydrides down the group. For the first group, LiH, NaH, KH, RbH and CHCH. Now, which one is more stable and why? So, LiH is more stable, and as we move down the group, stability decreases. That is, hydride easily release hydrogen in that case. So, we can say LiH is more stable hydride, whereas CSH is less stable. Lesser the size of metal atom, stronger will be the hydride. Now, these hydrides is violently reacting with water. If they are reacting with water, then they are forming NaOH and release the hydrogen gas. We can say the reaction is so exothermic that the evolved hydrogen catches fire. Now, few of the hydrides are very useful in, we can say, organic synthesis. For example, LiH and NaH. In organic chemistry, we will discuss this. The LiH will react with Al2Cl6, and similarly, it reacts with B2H6. They both belong to 13 group. So, both are reacting and forming some useful hydrides, which are used as a strong reducing agent in organic synthesis. That is, twice of NaBH4, lithium aluminium hydride, and this is sodium boron hydride. So, these two are very important synthesized product from these hydrides, which are used as a strong reducing agent in the organic synthesis. These are a very important reaction. So, these are the few uses of ionic hydride. They act as an reducing agent. They act as a solid fuel. They are used for the preparation of reducing agent like LiAlH4 and B2H6, NaBH4, not B2H6, NaBH4. And they can also remove traces of water from the organic compound as they react with water. We have discussed that, for example, sodium hydride is there, it will react with water and form the hydroxide and the hydrogen gas. So, meaning if there is any traces of water which is present, then we use ionic hydride to remove that water. So, now we will next discuss the covalent hydrides. So, when dihydrogen combined with P block element, or we can say non-metal, it result in the formation of covalent hydride. Now, what are the P block element? We starting from the 13 block, that is boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. So, whenever hydrogen reacting with these P block element, it forms the covalent hydride. Now, but there is difference in the type of hydrides which is formed by all these three types. For example, when hydrogen is reacting with the 13 group element, it forms the electron deficient hydride. This is the important point, why it is forming the electron deficient hydride, because in this case the outermost shell do not contain complete octet. Now, for example, BH3, then AlH3 whole and so on. So, these are generally formed by group 13 element. Electron deficient hydrides is formed by the group 13 element and have lesser number of electron than the required for writing the conventional formula. Now, for example, in case of BH3, we know that BH3 boron has 3 electron. So, it is not abiding that octet rule. So, it is electron deficient, hence it is act as a Lewis acid. These are the important terms. First point, only group 13 will form the electron deficient hydride. Why they are electron deficient? Because their outermost shell do not contain the complete octet for them. And yes, they are acting as an Lewis acid, that is, since they are deficient, so now they will accept the electron. So they act as an electron acceptor. What are the Lewis acids? These are the electron acceptor. Now, just opposite to electron deficient is the electron rich. Now, these are formed by electron rich hydrides are formed by group 15, 16 and 17 element. Now, for example, just imagine the hydride of nitrogen NH3, hydride of oxygen H2O, hydride of fluoride. So in all the three cases, yes, their octet is complete, but then also these electrons are acting as a lone pair. So now they are electron rich. Just for example, these are electron deficient because they have only these number of electron, the hydrogen is present, but in this case they contain more pair of electrons in this case. So, as the lone pair is present on each of the compound, so these are acting as an electron rich hydrides. Now, one of the important point, just like electron deficient are Lewis acid, they are Lewis base, we can say they are electron donor. As Lewis acid is electron acceptor, similarly, electron rich hydrides are electron donor. So maximum time in exam the question comes, find out the electron deficient hydride, and option is given to you all these three. So you have to find out 13 group elements are the electron deficient. In the similar way, if in the option it is asked about what is the electron rich hydride and you are given all these 4 to 5 different types, then those are which are having the lone pair in the formula, they are acting as an electron rich hydride. So we have discussed electron deficient, electron rich, now comes the electron precise hydride, meaning it has just an precise number of electron which are completing its octet. For example, group 14 element CH4. So now 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, so it has perfectly precise hydride in which all electrons are present, there is no deficiency, there is no excess of electron in this case. So these are called as an electron precise hydrides. These are generally formed by the group 14 elements. One of the example is CH4, then SiH4 and GeH4, and they have the tetrahedral geometry just like this. Now we will discuss the properties, physical properties of the covalent hydrides. So first of all, they possess the low melting point, or we can say boiling point, in comparison to the ionic hydrides, because in ionic there is a strong electrostatic force of attraction. In this case, these forces are weaker than that of ionic interaction. Then they do not possess free ions. Now, since ions are not present, meaning they are bad conductor of electricity, even in molten state as well as in the aqueous state. Now we will discuss the thermal stability. Thermal stability is decreased with increase in the metallic character, meaning out of CH4, NH3, then H2O and HF. Now, which one is more stable hydride? We can say which one is a more stable hydride. So answer is the HF. It has the strongest bond. So along the period, stability of hydrides is increasing because metallic character decreasing. But as we move down the group, we take one of the example of the nitrogen group, NH3, PH3, ASH3 and SBH3 and BiH3. Now, out of these, which one possessing the strong bond? NH3 is possessing the strong bond. Down the group, stability of hydrides now decreasing. So we can say along the period, stability of hydrides increase, down the group decrease. In a form of metallic character, we can say whenever there is decrease in metallic character, increase in stability of that hydrides. Decrease in metallic character, अब नीचे जा रहे हैं तो metallic character बढ़ रहा है, but stability उसकी क्या होती जा रही है, कम होती जा. तो metallic character is inversely proportional to the stability of hydrides. And metallic character of the element which is attached to hydrogen. If it is more metal, it will be less stable. If it is a non-metal, it will be stable towards thermal point. Now, two important uses of covalent hydrides. One is from the boron hydride and the silicon hydride. Boron hydrides are used as in fuel as well as fuel additives. Whereas silicon hydride, silicon hydrides. Now, hydrides of silicon with hydrogen is known as a silane, and these are a very high purity silicon which is used in the electronic gadgets. So this is one of the important use. Now the next classification is the metallic hydrides, which are also known as non-stoichiometric and the interstitial. Now each word is having its significant role in the hydride formation. Now why they are known as a metallic hydride? Because element of D and F block is used in the preparation. Hence they are known as a metallic hydride. Now why they are called as a non-stoichiometric? Reason, the hydride which is formed, for example LaH, lanthanum hydride, if we are writing, then it is not exactly LaH, it is LaH 2.87. so now it is not a stoichiometric, it is a non-stoichiometric, means there is not a fixed ratio, some amount is deficient in it. Then why it is called as a interstitial hydrides? Now in generally those hydrides which are already existing, they have a vacant space in between them. Now these hydrides why they are called as a interstitial hydride? Now for example, these are the D block elements, for example, and if this is one of the metal of the D block element and there is a void in between these element. Now in this space, because of hydrogen is of very small size, it trap in this space. Now after it is enclosed in these voids, the hydride which is formed, hence it is known as an interstitial hydride. Since hydrogen gas is trapped in these voids, so now the combination of metal and hydrogen is known as an interstitial hydride. ये जो वैकेंट स्पेस होता है, जब भी दो एटम्स आपस में या तीन एटम ज्वाइन होते हैं या कोई भी एक पैक्ड स्ट्रक्चर होता है, तो जो इसका वैकेंट स्पेस होता है, इसको हम इंटरस्टीशियल साइट्स बोलते हैं. नाउ सिंस हाइड्रोजन इज ट्रैप्ड इन दिस साइट्स, नाउ दैट एलिमेंट एग्जिस्ट इन दिस फॉर्म इज नोन एज एन इंटरस्टीशियल हाइड्राइड. सो वी कैन से दिस इज नॉट फॉलोइंग द लॉ ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट प्रोपोर्शन. जो हमने नॉन स्टोशियोमेट्रिक की बात की, वो यहाँ पे भी फॉलो हुई, दैट इट इज फॉर्मिंग TiH 1.5 to 1.8. सो नाउ इट इज नॉट अ फिक्स रेशियो, विच इज इन केस ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट प्रोपोर्शन, वेन एवर एन एलिमेंट कंबाइन, दे कंबाइन इन अ फिक्स रेशियो. बट इन दिस केस एलिमेंट्स आर नॉट कंबाइनिंग एनी फिक्स रेशियो, इट इज जस्ट रैंडमली trapping in these sites, hence they are known as an interstitial hydrides, or we can say non-stoichiometric hydrides. Now there is an interesting fact that elements of group 7, 8 and 9, they do not react with hydrogen, or we can say they do not form any hydride. So this periods or this position is known as an hydride gap. This is an important point, that is group 7, group 8 and group 9 do not form any hydride. That is why this region of the periodic table is called as a hydride gap. Now if we discuss about the properties, so they are the non-stoichiometric, they do not follow the law of constant proportion, we have already discussed. Now they are good conductor of a heat. Now as we have discussed, these are D and F block elements. Now metal is combining as an interstitial space or with a non-stoichiometric combination, metal is already there. So since metal is a good conductor of heat, these hydrides are also a good conductor of heat and electricity. Now at higher temperature, as we have discussed, there is a void and these hydrogen are trapped in this. So when at higher temperature these metal hydrides are heated, this hydrogen gas will release. And now release of hydrogen gas confirm that yes, hydrogen is present in these voids. So this is one of the use and important use. You have already done this in your class 10th. Whenever we convert a saturated into an unsaturated into a saturated compound, CH3 CH3, we can say, what is the catalyst we are using here? Nickel and platinum. What we are adding? Hydrogen gas. Now what is nickel and platinum? These are the D and D block elements. So this is used as a catalyst on the surface of which hydrogen is adsorbed. Now why hydrogen is adsorbing over the surface? Because of the voids which are present. So it is act like a surface over which hydrogen is getting attached. What is the surface here? Nickel and platinum having the vacant space in which this hydrogen gas is trapped. So we can say the property of transition metal to adsorb hydrogen gas in a catalytic reduction of hydrogen reaction for the preparation of large number of compounds. This is only the one compound I have discussed in class 10th, but there are large number of compounds which can be easily formed using nickel and platinum as a catalyst. Why they are using as a catalyst? Because they have tendency to absorb the hydrogen on its surface. So similar way, platinum and palladium, they are also having this property of adsorbing the hydrogen gas over its surface, or we can say they act as a storage center to store the hydrogen. So this is the use of these metallic hydrides or interstitial hydrides. They are used in number of reaction, or they are used as a storage center for hydrides, storage center for hydrogen gas.